Boundary's alarm actions make it really easy for you to share your alarms and notifications in the ops tools that you use every day with your team. In this video, I'll show you how to configure integration with VictorOps. So the first thing you need to do is within your VictorOps account, go through to Settings, and then in the top tab, there's the Integrations option. You'll see all the available VictorOps integrations. You want to click on Boundary and then enable the integration. That'll give you a unique API key, and you just need to copy that. Down at the bottom, you might also want to use the incident routing if you've got this set up. You'll see I've got one here with a routing key of ops, which will escalate to my ops team directly. It's an optional step, but if you're using it, that's where you'd make note of it now. So over in the boundary panel, here's my dashboard. I need to go and set up the action itself. So I go to Settings, Action. You'll see here's the ones I already have set up in my account, and I want to click on Add Action. Down at the bottom, here's the VictorOps option here. So I click on Add. I give this a specific name, and that's because I might have multiple VictorOps actions with different severities going to different escalations teams using different routing keys. So I'll just call this one VictorOps Lee for now. In the API key section, I want to paste in my key. Severity, I'll keep it critical, and the routing key I created already is called Ops, so I'll do that and save it. So there's my VictorOps Lee action created. So now I need to go through to alarms and actually attach this to one of my alerts. Now I've set up a test alert here, which is called CPU is high, which will alarm as soon as the CPU goes over 12% for longer than 15 seconds. And what I want it to do is then alert me through VictorOps. And of course, I could also add multiple actions, so I could have it email me as well if I wanted to. I can just keep listing those out. Click Enable, and because this is assigned to all of my sources, in around 15 seconds, I'll see an alert will be raised. And that will go straight through to my VictorOps console. Okay, my alarm's been raised now. If I click on it in Boundary, I can see that my Redis slave has gone over than 12%. So if I go and take a look in my timeline in VictorOps, there we go, it's raised a few of them. So here's my CPU usage is high. It'll raise one for every host, and when I see down, I can see some of the steps that have been taken. And also, when they resolve themselves, which this one obviously has now, it will also go back and turn green and acknowledge itself, and you'll see they'll keep coming through. So it's a two-way integration. Once something exceeds a threshold, it will raise an alert in VictorOps, and as soon as it fixes itself, it will also get cleared off automatically as well. So that's how you configure the integration with VictorOps and Boundary.